Welcome to Raising the Bar. Here, pressure meets precision as even the best builder skills are put to the test to construct a one-of-a-kind bar in under 8 hours.
Today, we've challenged this team of master craftsmen
to create their ultimate bar.
My name is Kirk Brown, and I build furniture for a living.
Been doing it for 17 years now. I prefer to do the jobs that are handcrafted for sure.
Creating something from a pile of rough lumber and turning it into something that's usable and tangible is, yeah, it's rewarding.
I'm not sitting behind a desk, that's for sure.
Guys, the rules are simple. You'll have 8 hours to build, it's gotta be handmade, and it must serve some George Dickel whiskey.
Perfect.
Team Woodwork, are you ready?
Ready?
Yep. Ready.
Yeah, time starts now.
I designed the bar. My personal style, I lean more towards like mid-century modern. Ari knows how to do all of these things with metal that I don't know.
Wow. This is the logic that's gonna drive the motors.
Our other teammate is Ari's brother, Adam. We've not even met.
He's an electrical engineer, Superman.
Yay. Team Woodwork is keeping it classy. With a hand-carved wooden bar, complete with a glowing George Dickel logo, stools made from real whiskey barrels, and a motorized whiskey pouring machine.
I'm working on the mechanical means of pouring the shots.
Well, Adam builds the motor for the pouring machine. The other two get down to business on the bar stools.
I just got done welding the last of the seat bases. They look really good. Next thing I'm gonna do, I'm gonna cut these pieces of pipe to 33 inches. It's gonna be our seat post.
Making stools with backs, and what I'm doing right now is getting ready to part the back off of the barrel.
There's whiskey in it!
Killer. That's the bag for the stool. That's your cod piece, man. I'm gonna then probably weld some straps on here to hope we'll bend over to support the base of the bar stools. Turn myself into a human vice.
Okay.
You love it?
Sure.
I love it.
He's gonna start assembling
multiple
the final weld. Once that's done, then we can attach our seat and almost have a complete stool. We'll see if they gotta work. They can't just be cool looking. You gotta sit in them.
3 hours into the build, the whiskey barrel stools are almost complete.
No!
Look, it came right out of the steel.
Yeah.
Oh my God. Came right out of the steel.
Yeah.
Oh my God.
Almost halfway through their build, Team Woodwork is falling apart.
I literally broke the weld out of the base metal here.
Hey,
it's
you know what?
Ari's welds aren't strong enough to support the 30-pound stools, and the clock is ticking.
Rusty steel doesn't like to be welded, so.
No comment.
That was a stupid error on my part.
Almost fatal. So now I will correct it. I'm gonna hog weld the sucker.
He's welding all the way around it now, so it won't pop off. Cross my fingers. Hey!
Yeah!
My work!
With the stool problem solved, time to bring on the carpentry.
This is the rest of the structure of the bar itself, where it's gonna start going together right down there.
While the woodwork is cruising, the pouring machine is going nowhere.
I'm RTF Emin.
What do you think? How much more time do you have doing that?
Which part? Pre-wiring?
Uh-huh.
A fair amount. Then I gotta make sure we can get the power supplies to work. I don't think there's a lot of pressure on me. My welds don't break.
Oh boy, here we go. I'm about to start veneering the panel, which is the fun part. I'm rolling contact cement out on the panel, and then I gotta put it on the other side of the veneer, and then we're gonna lay the veneer down on it.
I'm not worried yet, but when I get worried, you'll know.
If Adam doesn't get the electronics working with the motors, we buy hamsters. Have them in cages, chugging along.
Dusty!
Chaos.
The power supplies we're gonna have to modify to make the system work.
All the pressure's on Adam.
The logic that's gonna drive the motors. Trying to get the power supply tested. I'm hooking everything up right now, so that's where I'm at.
Builders, you're down to your final hour. Let's go.
We're not done. We're not close to done. I would like to be close to done, but I'm not. You're working?
Oh, all of a sudden now it's not working.
After 7 hours of tinkering, Adam still can't find a way to power the motor.
What do you need?
Oh my God.
No motor means no way to pour the whiskey.
We just need power to it.
And a bust for Team Woodwork.
Not working?
No.
Kind of stuck.
I don't know. How do we get this thing to turn?
Gerbils! Where's the gerbils?
I don't have enough time that I've been screwing with it. Hey.
What's that? How do we make it work? Rig it.
That's what I'm saying. We can rig a drill. I can rig the switch in a drill. You can press a button and it'll turn it.
Switch in a drill?
In the drill.
In the drill itself.
We can take the freaking drill apart.
We're modifying that drill to serve the purpose of all that stuff over there.
With just minutes left on the clock, Adam and Kurt go MacGyver style, scrambling to replace their broken motor with parts from a power drill.
This is f***ing duct tape it. It just needs to turn a drink.
Let's make sure it works before you tighten it down. Go ahead. Is it gonna do it again?
Uh-oh, what happened there?
What's wrong with the jigger?
What's wrong with our jigger, dude?
Oh, man.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Let me introduce you to a really good friend of mine, Jerry Graham. He's the master of whiskey with George Dickel.
Talk me through the build. Let me know what you actually did here. I mean, I see the logo on the front. It's beautiful.
Well, Ari and I worked together on doing the stools, and I modified the barrels. We cut out Dickel in the front of it, and having the whole thing glow was the idea.
Describe this contraption to me, because this wasn't in the original plans, right?
No, but it was a backup plan.
I mean, that's...
But all we needed to do was bend it and bypass the switch.
Yes. You're making it sound so simple.
No, they were freaking out. Yeah. I was cool about it.
Yeah. This is all good. We're really impressed. We've been watching you work all day. The craftsmanship is second to none, but I think you got the cliffhanger for them, huh?
I do. Guys, can it serve some George Dickel?
Of course it can.
Let's see it.
Here we go.
I'm impressed.
Awesome.
Success. Woo!
Very nice.
We all work together as a team. We built some cool stuff today. Machine didn't work too well, but hey, it works.
It works!
It works.
My God, it works!
Thanks for all your effort, and I think it's obviously a success. So with that, to George Dickel.
Yeah, George Dickel! Next time on Raising the Bar.
It'll be the first time I've ever built a car to a bar. For sure.
We challenge this team of custom metal fabricators to build their ultimate bar.
In the real world, we might have several weeks, but like in 8 hours,